You're listening to Clickthrough, a total user experience podcast brought to you by Government Technology Insider. Each episode features best practices and strategies from experts in federal modernization on using innovative technology to elevate total experiences. And now, here's your host, Kate Macri.
Hi, I'm Kate Macri. In this episode, we're taking a closer look at the future of public health. Transforming the health system into one centered on the customer experience, or CX, is an ongoing journey for our nation and federal agencies. This includes not just improved experiences for patients, but all relevant stakeholders working towards improved health outcomes. For our conversation today, I'm talking with Renae Facundus, Director of Interoperability and Analytics at the Department of Veterans Affairs, and Monica Rosser, Health Market Lead at Maximus. We're going to discuss how CX principles and interoperability initiatives are driving a new era of public health. Renae and Monica, thank you for joining us today.
Thanks so much for having us, Kate.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you very much.
So to start off our conversation, I want to open it up with a broad but simple question. Why is CX so important to the future of health? And what are some CX challenges currently facing the health system?
Okay, I think that's a great question. And simple as it seems, you know, I really want to take a second to define for you who the customer is for VA. I work out of the office of the Deputy Chief Information Officer there at VA, Director of the Interoperability and Analytics Pillar. And what our office does is we implement, oversee, and manage the technical aspects of the modernized electronic health record that's used to provide healthcare for over 9 million enrolled veterans. Our customer is the veteran, and we use and leverage health technology to support the clinicians that provide care to those veterans. So customer experience, right, is crucial to the future of healthcare because it directly impacts patient satisfaction, outcomes, and access to care. By prioritizing that experience for our veterans, healthcare providers can provide and get patient engagement and adherence to treatment plans, as well as ultimately lead to better healthcare outcomes for our veterans.
Oh, absolutely. So Renae touches on a really profound point in that the patient is the now ultimate consumer. What we're seeing is, frankly, an environment of more patients, more technology, more information at our fingertips than ever before. These digital interactions are really reshaping the patient experience and putting customer experience at the forefront, total experience. What we're having is the customer and patient as that ultimate navigator.
Yeah, I think that's a really interesting way of looking at it, especially when we're talking about veterans, you know, and providing that care for them. How has the healthcare continuum become more interconnected? And how is this impacting CX, especially when we're talking about care for veterans, which is this large, really, really big and complex endeavor? Renae, would love to hear your thoughts on that to start us off.
Yes. Right. So as we can become more interconnected through advancements in technology and data sharing, we are increasing the potential, right, for our veterans to significantly enhance their experience, and we're providing a more personalized and coordinated and efficient care. And so a great example of that is what we're doing with the patient portal. So DCIO is committed to initiatives such as implementing a patient portal that supports the patient's secure private access. You know, as Monica said before, right, we face some of the, you know, challenges of like data security, you know, as well as, you know, regulatory compliance and things like that. With this patient portal, we've been able to allow veterans anywhere they are, looking at all across the spectrum, right? We have low income, rural, minority, disabled veterans that now have access to care through their smartphones, right? Anywhere that they are, and it allows them to securely and conveniently engage in their healthcare outcomes.
Yeah. Could you tell me a little bit more about the patient portal? Was that born out of efforts to improve CX for veterans?
It was, and we've actually made a lot of great strides in improving that experience. And as a veteran myself, I actually use that portal. So I can actually speak personally to the actual customer experience there. The patient portal is also born out of a need, right, to move towards a more customer-centric health system. So we want our veterans to feel empowered. And the veterans, they do. They come in, and when you go into the hospital system there, they're able to access their own health records, engage with the providers there. So it's a great experience.
I'm a new veteran caregiver. I most recently was accepted into the caregiver programs for my veteran father. So being able to have the accessibility of information, that's one of the core tenets of customer experience with trust building. So being able to have this central point of navigation, being able to understand what is services and benefits, for myself and as well as my father, it's such a key component of both accessibility, that trust building, and being really utilization. Because understanding what's out there, understanding where you kind of fit into that larger care continuum, is something that is truly profound.
Yeah, I wanted to follow up on something that you both were kind of hitting on there about this idea of a customer-centric health system. Because I feel like when we talk about the health system, everyone expects it to be customer-centric, right? Like that's kind of like the point is that's what the health system is.
That's what we like to move towards, right?
Absolutely. You have it.
Looking at things from a customer-centric way, like how you're looking at things differently and what that means for healthcare and CX.
Basically, with VA, we've always had a patient portal, and that patient portal has, allowed veterans to be a part of care. But now, as we modernize the EHR, the veterans are now seeing more data being pulled into their EHR. As Monica alluded to earlier, you have their veterans, their caregivers, they're able to see more of what the VA is doing. We're partnering right now with other agencies like, DOD and SSA, and we're looking at a more federated view of a patient's record. And so veterans are now able to actually engage and see what's in their record and have more engagement. And I feel that this engagement allows them to adhere better to treatment plans, right? They feel more of a role in it, where I think previously it was more like, okay, here's your, here's your summary, here's where you're going. Yeah. But we're definitely seeing more engagement from veterans and patients this way.
Pete, I think you bring up a great point, right? So the point-to-point care continuum has been customer centric, right? Patient centric, you with your healthcare provider. But what we've seen in technology advancements is that digital interaction might take the place of that one-to-one conversation, or more often than not, augment it. So when we talk about CX in the larger total experience in the larger scope of the future of healthcare, it's that this digital enablement that Renee profoundly describes as this care consortium, all of the pieces of the puzzle are now at this tips of fingertips, where you have the patient as the center. But now you have information sources and input that, really expand the reach of how we're defining the customer experience, and as well as the overall, whole health treatment plan.
So it's almost like technology is helping to create a more holistic picture and approach to a customer-centric health system, right?
Yeah, that's absolutely it. That's the ultimate goal, right? And that's what we've both been working on for decades.
Yeah.
Together, parallel together of this, how is technology the enablement? How is this digital medicine, digital care, understanding the menu of benefits and services, especially, you know, to our veterans, caregiver, the community that holds them in their hearts, but how does that technology enablement, provide a more equitable access to care, a better care experience, as well as we're hoping more successful outcomes.
And like you said, we're leveraging technology. I heard yesterday someone say that technology should be invisible. For that customer experience, I think that's important, right? They shouldn't feel like it's something that's too hard or that they can't access or anything. We're trying to leverage technology to make lives better, to make the customer experience better, right? To have better health outcomes and, as Monica said, equity and care.
Yeah. So building on that a little bit, as we're talking about how technology is really helping to provide this more holistic approach focused on CX, how does data interoperability improve health outcomes in that vein? Like why does a CX approach to data interoperability so important for the future of health?
Right. So data interoperability provides that holistic, comprehensive view of patient data. We have, like I said, so many sources of data here in VA, and we're partnering with our other federal agencies, in the community before a veteran would go as a snowbird down to Florida, right? And they would have to go to a VA down there, but that VA wasn't connected to the VA back in their home state. Now, not only can they go to another VA when they're on vacation, but they can go out in community to partners that are partnering with VA, and all of that data is brought back in and reconciled to their record. And with data interoperability, we're looking at enhanced patient engagement, and that engagement, it has the benefits in mind, right, of adopting like a customer experience approach that's crucial for the future of healthcare, for several reasons. Among those reasons would be, as we talked earlier about health equity, public health. That's another area and where data interoperability it plays a huge role, because we have interoperability with CDC and with state immunization systems. So that allows us, especially as we came through COVID, to understand how that interconnectedness and how that data interoperability between the states and the federal government was so important to public healthcare.
Absolutely.
Data interoperability, as Renae said, gives us that holistic picture. So when we're able to see, the whole health of the patient, individual, that's when you can be proactive. That's when we're starting to see kind of predictive components of health, both from a clinical care setting and also that outreach. What you look like you might be in need of X, Y, or Z services. That's where, we could, as organizations to support and augment, be proactive in giving those services and benefits for those in need.
Yeah. And you could use digital tools, right, to distribute even health information, health education. I know that in VA, we promote, disease prevention, health information about, wellness, mental health wellness for veterans, and it honestly gets across a socioeconomic status. Like, regardless of your geographic location or socioeconomic status, veterans are able to take advantage of the digital tools used by VA to promote all overall wellness and health.
Yeah. So Renae, you mentioned how now veterans can go to any VA in the US and, their patient data is consistent across the board. It's not like you're siloed into or restricted into like one area or location. I want to pull on that thread a little bit. How does this concept of patient choice and patient flexibility play into improving CX for all stakeholders involved in the health system?
Yeah. So for patients, for our veteran patients, the tools that allow them the ability to make choices, it's all about choice, right? They have a choice in their healthcare. They have an active role in that healthcare. And that choice allows them to select the services that best meet their needs and preferences. You know, so now we have we're building a better healthcare system, right? That makes it more patient-centered approach and enabling like clear communication. And even on the other side with clinicians, it actually enables better empathy, right? With the care team management and the clinicians, because now you have an open communication between that patient understanding their preferences and choices, and that clinician, right? Being able to provide better response and understanding of what a patient actually needs. So it guides those areas that need improvement and priority in a patient's care. So by prioritizing that patient choice, the system as a whole can move towards improved healthcare outcomes and greater satisfaction with healthcare and our veterans and overall health.
Yeah. Monica, would love your perspective on that as well.
It's profound what Renae and team have been able to do from an interoperability perspective. The care and community initiatives that we have seen have been a real expansion of care for our veterans, caregivers, and their beneficiaries. Getting the data back as the whole health record, it drives better outcomes. It drives a holistic treatment plan. It is a understanding of that horizontal record that follows both benefits and care services. So it's the core of when we talk about whole health and we talk about the building blocks of this whole health idea and the holistic record of interoperability and data sharing.
Yeah. So I want to take what we're talking about and kind of zoom out a little bit. And I'm curious, how does CX and a human-centered design approach help build trust in the overall public health system and government for improved health outcomes? How does technology come into play in all of that?
Well, I'll start by saying that a CX and human-centered design approach builds trust. Right? It builds trust between the patients and the providers. This trust will ultimately lead to better healthcare outcomes, leveraging technology, as we've been sitting here talking about, right? Because sometimes technology, you get to where people don't trust the technology, but they trust, right, that the providers are able to use that technology to provide them a care that strives to meet the needs and preferences of the patient. By designing the products, services, and processes veterans use to interact with their VA providers, we're able to fulfill their needs, right? Their wants. We can demonstrate, even through our public health care system, that there's relevance and commitment to the population, to our veteran populations. VA's vision for change is not only veteran-centric, but it's veteran-driven. Right? We're putting our veterans in control of their healthcare experience. VA employees across the country are already putting human-centered design into practice and with great results. We use technology and stuff like telehealth appointments, right? Booking appointments, follow-ups, benefits. We have care teams that get out there. We're reducing barriers, to making healthcare more inclusive. And those are just some of the incredible things that VA is doing and really, leading in the area in one of the biggest healthcare systems, in our nation, if not, in the world.
Whenever I'm asked about why I get so excited about customer experience and total experience, I always say it's the underpinning of enablement. So when you have the patient as the ultimate consumer who have access now to their preferences, both in delivery, have an information at the tips of their fingertips, understanding that accessibility component. But when you model a system and have that customer experience as the pillar of enablement, that is the ultimate way that you're setting the stage of trust and care and caregiving. So all of the pieces that Renae, just all of those key building blocks, but CX is consumer enablement in the way that your preference of delivery.
Yeah, I really love the way both of you talk about this, because I feel like, when you strip away the acronyms and the buzzwords and all the IT terminology, and you really get down to it, like you said, Monica, it's about enablement. And I really liked what Renae said about how you're veteran driven. I mean, that's literally the definition of customer experience for the VA, right? Is for it to be veteran driven.
Absolutely.
Technology that puts the veteran at the center, right?
Right. It's coming back to the mission and the people that you serve. Yes. I feel like that's really the heart of it.
And there is no greater mission, right? There is no greater mission than what we are doing here.
Yeah.
Making this process, this care continuum, looking at the holistic health of our veterans and their beneficiaries, there is no greater mission than this.
Absolutely. And like I said, we strive, and like Monica said, we have spent so many years, right, trying to make sure that technology can aid, right? You have areas where you aid in sharing evidence of care, right? Evidence of the services that are provided. There is no greater mission than what we provide to now war fighters, our veterans, their families, their caregivers, and those that support them.
Absolutely. Couldn't agree more. Before we wrap up today, is there anything else either of you would like to add that you want to leave our audience with?
I just really appreciate the opportunity to be able to talk a bit about, that veteran experience, about being veteran centric and the importance of the mission that we're doing. Because I think overall, the use of technology, the emerging technologies that we use will go towards even beyond veteran care, but our healthcare system as a whole. So thank you for that today. I appreciate the time.
Of course.
Yeah, same. And a special thank you for Renae and her team. What they are successfully embarking on with EHM modernization is paramount. It is a profound modernization effort that has ripple effects through each of the care and benefit processes that we see. And it is remarkable what has been done thus far.
Well, thank you, Renae and Monica, for joining us today. And a big thank you to our listeners for tuning in. Join us next time for more strategies for optimizing total user experiences from government to you.
If you want to hear more proven strategies for leveraging innovative technology to improve total experience in federal government, please subscribe to this podcast or visit us at our website, governmenttechnologyinsider.com. This podcast was produced by Government Technology Insider and sponsored by Maximus.